Okay, I'll do some K-Rino. Come on, what's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel again. Today we've got K-Rino back on the channel. You guys went crazy when I put the other K-Rino track on, and I wasn't expecting that kind of track, to be honest. But yo, the kind of knowledge that was in that track was mad. So even me, I wanted to find out. Even though that track made me a little bit paranoid, I wanted to find out. So today we're back again with Secret War. This could literally be about any of this conspiracy theories we might know about. So I'm ready to jump into it. So yeah, leave a like, subscribe, and let's hear what he's got to say. Or teach, should I say. Don't make me paranoid again, you know.
For those who don't know what's being done, it's time for me to tell you exactly what's being done. But more importantly, who's the one doing it? And at the same time, tell you a little bit about what they do.
It's time for them to teach us about what people are doing in this world, yeah? And more importantly, who's doing it and what they do. Okay, come on then.
And how they try to turn us into that. Let's go. This is the new normal, everyone's too carnal. When the strong become suppressed, effects are too harmful.
Being carnal is like a state of being, isn't it? It's like, how do I explain the meaning of carnal? I'll write it down. But yeah, being carnal is a state of being. Sorry.
When the strong become suppressed, effects are too harmful. Who are the life-altering pushers of this type of madness? Black men are glad to put a dress on as a rite of passage. The self-degrading path to cash deeply impacts your mental. The consequential aftermath of this ain't accidental. So senseless, we don't even see our own divinity. Defenseless against this war on our masculinity.
What's this dress that he's talking about? Is he talking about, like, is he talking on the topic of, like, homosexuality? Or is he talking about a type of cult or something? Like, what's this dress thing that he's talking about? You know, and what is it got to do with the sisters? Like, is it a thing that is taken from the sisters? Is it inspired by the sisters? Is it something that's supposed to be just for the sisters and the men have taken it? What is it?
Track and make distractions to keep you from claiming greatness back. Covered our eyes so with him we won't break our ties and never realize that it's in our hands the power lies.
Yo. Yo. Yeah. Now, I think he's talking about the devious ways of the devil in a way. Sort of talking about how we're being controlled from the back, where things look good in the front, but before you realize it, you've been controlled to the point where you can't come back from where you've gone to. You know, mind vision, like it's this thing where you need to pay attention to what's going on around you, depending on what you believe in or you know, the kind of things that you do. are you doing the right thing? Is that thing that you're doing, does that line up with your life in a way? Is it supposed to be there? Is it distracting you from doing something you're supposed to be doing? You know? What is it that's in your way?
Eyes and never realize that it's in our hands, the power lies.
No. You gotta realize that the power is it literally in your hands? And it is literally in your hands, no matter the situation. You can come out of it, or you can go deeper into it by your actions, you know? So watch out. Every minute it feels like they just keep killing us more and more. Yeah, there's 3 minutes left, like, there's some stuff that is going to be said, and I'm just thinking, what's he going to drop on me that I'm just going to be paranoid about for the next week again? Like, literally, the last video, I was so paranoid, I was thinking, like, it was Truman Show again, everywhere. Like, literally, I was watching my back, I'm just like, please don't, no one attack me or something.
They're
stacking up the bodies even more and more. They're stacking up the bodies that they keep in score. Yo. And all the stuff is in front of us and we ignore it. You know, what are these? Yo. Anyway.
No. All of the original is scriptural, so now you see us visible before the world carrying out their rituals. The route consists of sex on many casting couches, Luciferian messages encrypted in the outfits.
Okay. A lot of stuff going on there. Obviously, he's talking about sexual stuff on couches. Obviously, we all know what that's about. Reproduction. What was the other bit he said? Sorry.
Many casting couches, Luciferian messages encrypted in the outfits.
Luciferian messages in their outfits. Is he talking about like slutty outfits and like maybe statements on clothes and stuff like that? You know, what are these outfits that he's talking about? Is it the bikinis as well? Is it that kind of thing?
In messages encrypted in the outfits, the contract writers who hire you require this and fly you through the cycle of the Zionist entitlements. Top rabbis and pedophile Jews get their values from the Babylonian Talmud.
The people who write up your contracts put you in the system so you can't avoid it. You can't get around it. You know? Rabbis and what? I'm guessing spiritual leaders. That the other thing he said was another spiritual leader getting their values from a corrupt system.
Their values from the Babylonian Talmud.
From the Babylonian Talmud. Am I saying it right? Babylonian Talmud. Now, I know someone is going to educate me, but please. But I don't know what that is. Yeah, I don't know what that is. So somebody, please educate me down below. I know there's someone who knows what it is and is going to tell me exactly what it is. Like, all my questions on the last video, you guys answered all of them, you know. And I was surprised. Like, some of them I was like, really? It's like, it's right there in front of us and we don't even see it. This is what he's talking about here.
Get their values from the Babylonian Talmud. Father Torah, they live by these rules. Sex trafficking, raping babies younger than preschool. These principles are used in their control of entertainment and applied to many who have a desire to be famous. So they pay rappers and actors who are chasing after dreams, then present you as a girl on the front of a magazine. Now,
oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Literally. I mean, you can ask the question of why are these head teachers and stuff doing this, you know? And, you know, a simple answer could just be they need to make money for the school to survive. But, I mean, what's the difference between, you know, how do I say it? How do you know that what you're doing is right or wrong when you kind of need to sacrifice something to gain something else? I'm not saying that schools should start doing that. No. Because that's completely wrong. What I'm saying is we live in an age where any little mistake you make, someone's going to jail. Someone's getting sued. You know, someone's doing this. Do you know what I mean? But what is the best thing to do in those kind of situations? Because I'm sure it's more than just a decision to be made by one person. You know? And even in that decision, that action that they're taking, they should know that it's completely wrong. Do you know what I mean? But what do you do for the attention? You know, all that kind of stuff. It all plays into it, and it's just mind-boggling how somehow, it always comes back round to a few things. You know, greed, pleasures. You know, being selfish. Like, it all comes down to that. No matter where you're from, like, literally. Anyway.
...and actors who are chasing after dreams, then present you as a girl on the front of a magazine. Now the plan has been employed, leaving manhood void, so in the eyes of black boys, the male image is destroyed.
What was that bit? What did he say?
Manhood void, so in the eyes of black...
Sorry.
Of entertainment and applied to many who have a desire to be famous. So they pay rappers and actors who are chasing after dreams, then present you as a girl on the front of a magazine. Now the plan has been employed, leaving manhood void, so in the eyes of black boys, the male image is destroyed.
I didn't hear another plan destroyed, another planet discovered. I didn't hear that bit properly. But he was talking about how whatever that is corrupts little black boys' minds and it takes their manhood away, basically. What is all this? What is going on here?
Now the plan has been employed, leaving manhood void, so in the eyes of black boys, the male image is destroyed. We're casualties in a sacred war. No. Every minute is just feeling like they keep getting us even more. No. They're stacking the bodies up like they're keeping score.
Like they're keeping score, you know.
No. Every sign that they're showing us daily, we ignore. No. Rap music is buried in a feminized era. Experimental chemicals like Epoprofera or you.
Experimental chemicals like what? Someone's gonna break it down. Please let me know what he actually said there. And what is that?
Buried in a feminized era, experimental chemicals like Epoprofera are used scientifically as a medical weapon to shift our testosterone levels into recession. They lie and twist the truth plus the A.
Is he talking about changing genders and stuff? You know, is that the drug that they use to lower your testosterone levels so that your what's it called? So your female juices start flowing, basically. Estrogen, isn't it? Estrogen, that's it.
But testosterone levels into recession. They lie and twist the truth, plus the able of comatose. And scientific proof is still labeled as homophobic. So now you stand afraid to say what's in ya, cause you know speaking against the gay agenda may offend the paper spenders.
Yo, it's true, it's true. Do you know how true that is? And it affects everyone today. Bruv, you can't chat to them, you know. You can't. You know, even if you don't mean any harm to them, or you know, you don't mean any trouble. Bruv, it will be trouble for you. Literally in every workplace, you know, in every important area, whatever, if there are any of them there, you've got a problem, you know, because you can't speak your mind without getting attacked. They're going to attack you some way, somehow, about something that you said, which they believe you shouldn't have said, and then they kick up a whole fiasco about, you know, what you said. You know, I've almost been... Literally, any little thing, discrimination, you know, any little thing is discrimination. It's being everything bad, and they kick up such a big fuss that they always win, you know. And also, this happens in workplaces a lot, yeah. I've been a victim of this, but I mean, I didn't like to make noise about it. Now, there's a lot of straight people, yeah, that work in certain places. And then you have the people who are not straight who come to work in those places. The people who are not straight are the ones who are more susceptible to getting a promotion, you know. And it's not that they can't do the work. They can do the work. But it's just when they have that thing, it's like the companies don't know what to do, so they just keep promoting them. Meanwhile, there's people who, you know, are orientated as straight who don't get those opportunities just because they're normal. You know, it's a serious thing that needs to get looked at.
And afraid to say what's in ya, cause you know speaking against the gay agenda may offend the paper spenders, the great pretenders.
It may offend the paper spend. It's true, because they've got money as well. You know, it may offend them, and when you offend them, no money's coming your way. Another thing.
That may offend the paper spenders, the great pretenders push abomination. This song was made to conjure conversation, not for hate and condemnation. When you love people, you.
This song was made to start conversations, yeah, not for hate and condemnation. Yeah, this song was made to make us talk about it. This is why we're here, we're talking about it. And I know you guys are going to help me talk about it. I love it when you guys talk about stuff. You know? Now, let's get back into it.
This song was made to conjure conversation, not for hate and condemnation. When you love people, you handle them with patience. Because it's not okay to blame the uneducated for Satan's machinations.
It's not okay to blame the uneducated for Satan's what? Look, for someone who isn't educated or ignorant, you can't blame them for being that way, because they just haven't come across it before. You know, once you have come across it, yeah, and it's beneficial to you, then it's up to you to fix that issue. It's up to you to go forth with that thing. It's up to you to educate on that issue so that they can get out of it. You've got more responsibility than you think, you know.
Because it's not okay to blame the uneducated for Satan's machinations. The scheme against the black family smoked the and self-respect is no longer the focus. But truth can end the hypnosis, though some damage has been done. But how can you fight a war if you don't even know you in one?
How do you fight a war if you don't even know you're in one? It's true, you know. It's true. That silent war is happening. You know, how do you fight a war if you don't even know you're in one? You know? And this is down to this is down to, you know, where you are, where you're staying, all that kind of stuff. You know? If it's not being seen anywhere, it's never gonna be seen. You know, but what are you actually looking at? You know, are you actually looking at the right thing? Is your mind in the right place when you're looking for this thing? You know, what are you doing it for? Are you doing it to pass on the information to the next generation? Or are you in it to find that for yourself and die with yourself? A lot of people have their own answers to that. But, yeah, let's keep going. In a secret war. No, 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 no. Every minute is just feeling like they keep killing us even more. No, 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 no. They're stacking the bodies up like they're keeping score. No, 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 no. Every sign that they're showing the state we ignore. Yeah. No, 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 no. I like that beat, you know. I like that beat, man. Maybe a little bit more bass, but I like that beat. Alright, so there's K-Rino, Secret War. Now, I expected it to be a bit more, like, a bit more punchy, a bit more direct, like the other track was. You know, I thought there was gonna be some more stuff about, like, oh, what's it called? Conspiracy theories and you know, that kind of thing. You know, what's happening right in front of your eyes, you know. Yearly flu, all that kind of stuff. I thought that would be part of it, but anyway, this is Secret War by K-Rino. Push your comments down below. Let me know what you thought about the song. Let me know what you thought about the review. And I'll see you soon. Take care.